Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. First of all, let me say this. This video is a supplement to the hybrid system explanation videos available on this channel. And it compares the fuel efficiency of each system based on their specification sheets. This is not actual driving fuel efficiency, so please keep that in mind. If you're not familiar with these systems, we recommend watching these videos first. You can find the links in the description. Note that hybrid mentioned in this video are self-charging hybrids. There are three types of hybrid systems: power split, series, and parallel. Due to its structure, the parallel system cannot compete with the other two in terms of fuel efficiency. Therefore, this video will focus on the power split and series systems. The power split system is used by Toyota, while the series system is used by Nissan. Honda's system operates fundamentally as a series hybrid, but switches to parallel hybrid depending on the driving situation. So it is classified as a series parallel system. The details of these systems are explained in the videos mentioned earlier. So this video will briefly explain each system. Toyota's system uses a planetary gearset as a power split device to divide and combine the power from the engine and two electric motors, while also functioning as a CVT, continuously variable transmission. When driving with the engine, the CVT allows the engine to operate in its high-efficiency rotational speed range, making the system highly efficient. However, since it can be considered a gasoline engine vehicle with a CVT assisted by electric motors, it shares the same weaknesses as a conventional gasoline engine vehicle with a CVT. Nissan's system has the engine dedicated solely to driving the generator, and it is not mechanically connected to the wheels. The vehicle is driven solely by the electric motor. Therefore, the engine can operate in its high-efficiency rotational speed range, regardless of the vehicle speed. The AC electricity from the generator is converted to DC by the traction inverter, and then converted back to AC to operate the electric motor, resulting in some losses. This graph shows the torque curve of a typical electric motor. Electric motors generate maximum torque from 0 RPM to low speeds, so vehicles equipped with a series hybrid system have very powerful acceleration from a standstill. However, because efficiency decreases at high rotational speed range, fuel economy is not as good during highway driving. Honda's system is similar to Nissan's. But during highway driving, it drives the vehicle by directly connecting the engine to the wheels. The values you are about to see are all for vehicles made for the Japanese market. This is because hybrid vehicles are very popular in the Japanese market, resulting in a wide variety of models and making comparisons easier. The WLTC mode fuel economy for this market does not include the extra high-speed phase at 130 km per hour. Therefore, the highway phase value is for speeds up to 100 km per hour. First, let's review the fuel efficiency advantage of hybrids using a Toyota sedan. The hybrid model's engine is the 1NZ-FXE, while the gasoline model's engine is the 1NZ-FE. Both have a displacement of 1.5 liters. The hybrid model produces 54 kilowatts and 111 newton meters, while the gasoline model produces 80 kilowatts and 138 newton meters. The hybrid model has lower output because its engine is an Atkinson cycle engine, which prioritizes fuel efficiency over power output. This channel provides a detailed video explaining the Atkinson cycle. If you're interested, please check it out. You'll find the link in the description. The hybrid model's electric motor produces 45 kilowatts and 169 newton meters, assisting the low output engine. This gives the hybrid model outstanding fuel efficiency. We will compare vehicles from three companies in the same category. Toyota's engine is a 1.3 liters three-cylinder. Nissan's is a 1.2-liter three-cylinder. Honda's is a 1.5-liter four-cylinder. The output is 67 kilowatts and 120 newton meters for Toyota, 60 kilowatts and 103 newton meters for Nissan, and 78 kilowatts and 127 newton meters for Honda. We can see that Nissan's smaller displacement engine has lower output. The electric motor output is 59 kilowatts and 141 newton meters for Toyota, 85 kilowatts and 280 newton meters for Nissan, and 90 kilowatts and 253 newton meters for Honda. Toyota's output is low because the Toyota hybrid system drives the vehicle by combining the power of the engine and the electric motor. We can see that Nissan, which does not use the engine to drive the vehicle at all, combines a low output engine with a high output electric motor. Honda, which uses the engine to drive the vehicle when running on highways, has the highest engine output. Let's take a look at the fuel economy. It goes without saying that the hybrid system alone does not determine fuel economy. But even so, Toyota's fuel efficiency is outstanding. In cases where a model has multiple grades, the figures have been selected according to a set of rules to ensure fairness. There is one more point that should be of interest. What is the highway fuel economy like for Honda, which has an engine direct drive mode, compared to Nissan, which does not have one? The graph shows the high speeds phase values, when the medium speeds phase is set to 100. We can see that Nissan's decline rate is high, but it is not as bad as we had imagined. Next, we will compare three minivans. Toyota's engine is a 1.8-liter four-cylinder. Nissan's is a 1.4-liter three-cylinder. Honda's is a 2.0-liter four-cylinder. The output is 72 kilowatts and 142 newton meters for Toyota, 72 kilowatts and 123 newton meters for Nissan, and 107 kilowatts and 175 newton meters for Honda. The electric motor output is 70 kilowatts and 185 newton meters for Toyota, 120 kilowatts and 315 newton meters for Nissan, and 135 kilowatts and 315 newton meters for Honda. Comparing Nissan and Honda, the electric motor output is similar, but Honda has a higher engine output. Fuel economy. Toyota is dominant, while Nissan and Honda are at a similar level. However, when comparing the medium speeds phase and high speeds phase, we can see that Nissan's decline rate is indeed greater. Finally, we will compare three SUVs. Toyota's engine is a 2.5-liter four-cylinder. Nissan's is a 1.4-liter three-cylinder turbo. Honda's is a 2.0-liter four-cylinder. The output is 131 kilowatts and 221 newton meters for Toyota, 106 kilowatts and 250 newton meters for Nissan, and 107 kilowatts and 175 newton meters for Honda. It is clear that even small displacement Nissan engines can generate large torque thanks to their turbochargers. The electric motor output is 88 kilowatts and 202 newton meters for Toyota, 150 kilowatts and 330 newton meters for Nissan, and 135 kilowatts and 315 newton meters for Honda. All of them are 4WD vehicles, but Toyota and Nissan use electric 4WD systems, while Honda uses a mechanical 4WD system with a propeller shaft. Therefore, Toyota and Nissan are equipped with rear drive motors. But since they are unlikely to drive the rear wheels in WLTC mode, the output of the rear motors can be ignored. Fuel economy. The latest model of the Honda CR-V is not yet available in Japan. Therefore, please be aware that these figures are from the pre-facelift model. Toyota had overwhelming fuel efficiency performance in the previous two categories. But in this category, the gap has narrowed. Let me try to speculate on the reason for this. The system total maximum torque of the Toyota hybrid system is not simply the sum of the engine torque and the electric motor torque. However, for comparison, we will compare the torque obtained by simply adding the values together, with the maximum torque of the electric motors in other vehicles. The torque from Toyota's simple addition of engine and motor torque is about the same as the electric motor torque of other vehicles for compact and minivan categories. However, in SUV category, Toyota's simple addition of engine and motor torque significantly exceeds that of other vehicles. This is purely speculative, but the general rule that higher output means worse fuel efficiency in gasoline engine vehicles may also apply to hybrid vehicles. Return to the fuel economy comparison. When comparing the medium speeds phase and high speeds phase of Nissan and Honda, it is clear that Nissan experiences a larger decrease. Nissan has announced the launch of its next-generation hybrid system. They claim that the system improves fuel efficiency by 9% total and by 15% in high speeds phase compared to the current system. What is noteworthy is that the next-generation system does not have an engine direct connection mode like Honda's, and instead improves fuel efficiency by enhancing the overall system efficiency. The engine will be replaced from the current 1.5-liter turbo engine to a 1.5-liter naturally aspirated engine. According to Nissan engineers, they have specialized the engine for generator drive by sacrificing throttle response, among other factors, improving thermal efficiency from the current 39% to 42%. However, there are also concerns. If the battery charge is depleted, the drive motor of a series hybrid vehicle cannot transmit more energy to the drive wheels than the energy generated by the engine. If the battery power is depleted on a long uphill climb, the vehicle, weighing over 2 tons, must be propelled by a 1.5-liter naturally aspirated engine. Let's look forward to the launch and see what solutions Nissan's engineers have come up with. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.